Let's just say you need to check through a column vector of data values to see if it meets a certain condition, or only execute a function if it meets a certain condition. In this example, we need control statements that allow us to control the flow of a program. There are quite a few control statements you can learn in programming, but the most useful and simplest control statements are the for loop statement, the if and else statements. So let's just say I have data on the average income for different job roles across, you know, US cities. I want to loop through average income and check if there are incomes greater than or equal to 90,000. If there are incomes that are 90K plus, I want to tag it as high and store the tag label high in a vector or a list. And for those that fall below this figure, they can be tagged low to medium. So to do this and save myself the trouble of manually checking through the data and tagging it myself, I'll make use of a for loop and an if and else statement. So my for loop will check through each data value in average income, iterating through each value one at a time. My if statement will check if each value is greater than or equal to 90K. And if that's the case, it'll be labeled high income and stored in a new column vector. Otherwise, it will be just labeled as low to medium income. So I have an empty vector tied to a variable called income level, ready for storing the tag labels high or low to medium in this vector. This is going to be a new column vector that we'll add to our income data later, where the high label corresponds to all cases that are 90K plus, and the low med corresponds to all cases that fall below 90K. So then the way to read this block of code here is that for each index value, or for I, starting at index 1 to the last index number, or however long average income is, check if the income value sitting at that particular index is greater than or equal to 90,000. If it is, append this onto the end of income level, append the string high onto the end of income level, and keep going through the next value, and if it also meets this condition, append onto the end of income level this value high here, and so on and so forth. Else, for everything else that doesn't meet this condition, append the value or the string character low med onto the end of income level. And the brackets here, or the curly brackets here, just help us keep track of everything that belongs inside a statement. So let's run this empty vector here and this for, if, and else setup we have here, and then print the income level tag labels. So we'll run this. And let's have a look at what it produced here. Okay, as you can see, we have some tag labels that categorizes high income level jobs from low to medium level income jobs, which is useful to have. And we didn't have to manually check the data ourselves to find this. In the next video, I'll show you how to create your own function so you can make use of repeatable code.